And I'm Tom, and we're from the band Keen, and you are watching Gaztea.
Hirugarren eguna da Bilbao BBK Live-en, eta kartelburua partekatua da. Keen eta Garbage ditugu, eta gurekin hemen ditugunak Tom eta Richard dira. Hi, how are you doing?
Good, I was just nodding along like I understood everything that you just said.
I know, you didn't understand anything?
You speak very fast in Spain, so it's quite difficult to follow. Because I did speak a bit of Spanish at school, but very slowly.
Yeah, this isn't the Spanish, even, it's not the Spanish. So yes, it was very, very slow.
Because we're in the Basque, right? Okay, so that's even more difficult. Not even going to go there.
Richard speaks Basque.
No, I don't, I'd speak bullshit.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you to describe a little bit your album. It's a strange land, so I'm going to ask you to, if you have to put it in a paper, to draw it in a paper, what will we see in the strange land of Keen?
I don't know. A mess.
A mess?
Yeah, a terrible mess. Some four very confused men walking through life, probably.
I don't know if it was a mess, but I heard that when you were recording the new songs, it was more difficult to find an end to the song, because maybe it was more difficult to say, okay, this is the song, we are not going to move it anymore.
I think it's always difficult to decide when you've finished a record, because you have lots of ideas and you always change things and you go back and you change one song and then you think, oh, I could do that for all the other songs, and every time you do something. So you eventually you just have to say, right, it's done, it's finished.
Okay, so one of the things that makes difference in Keen is that for a rock band, that the piano is very, is the main instrument. I'm going to ask you if you still compose beginning from the piano.
Well, Tim starts with the songs. He's not here. Don't know where he is. But yeah, I think he writes mostly on the piano, a little bit on the guitar. But yeah, it's always kind of been the instrument that's best suited us as a band. I'm not really sure why. There's no explanation.
There is no explanation. But did you try other instruments, or did you, since you started as a band, did you investigate other places?
Yeah, because, I mean, Tom's very modest, but he's a very good guitar player, and Jesse also. And so we do, yeah, sometimes we have a few different instruments. I mean, there's a couple of songs where Tom might play the guitar, but basically it's the piano is the sort of heart of the musical side. And then when you have that and Tom's voice, there's basically no room for anything else, because they're both so sort of big and dominating. Yes. So that's all you need. And a bit of drums and a bit of bass.
Is he dominated in all the areas?
Volume-wise, in terms of noise and presence within, you know, you might not know if Jesse's on the bus or if Tim's on the bus or if I'm on the bus, but you always know when Tom's on the bus, except when he's fast asleep, which is, you know, most afternoons.
Okay, so you just came from Scotland, if I'm not wrong.
Yes.
Yes, and now you are going to Portugal. What plan do you have for this... summer?
I don't really know. I can't really remember. I mean, we're doing lots of festivals. It's nice to come to this part of the world. I mean, we thought we were going to get sunshine and warm weather, but it's just not like that in Bilbao, no?
No. Two days ago, yes, but not now.
Okay, well, that's a shame. So we're going to head to, we're playing at Cascais, Lisbon on Monday, I think. And then I don't really know after that. We've got festivals all around Europe.
I read today that you are coming to Iruña, to Pamplona, in October.
Yeah, that's right. I guess it's been announced. I'm getting a nod. Yeah, we're doing a massive European tour. We're actually doing three shows in Spain, in Madrid and Pamplona and Barcelona, which is great, because I'm not sure, I don't think we've actually played in Pamplona before. So it's really exciting for us. It's a new city, but, you know, we always have a great time in Spain, and It's going to be a fun tour, so a bit of autumn sunshine for us and some music for you.
I hope so. Thank you very much and enjoy tonight.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having us.
You've got to Flies
Yeah, it's a beautiful place.
It was sponsored by a beer company, so we don't remember very much of it.
Yeah, it was our first time in Bilbao, I think. And so you just, you know, you see the... I guess the main thing is that you drive into town and you see the museum, the Guggenheim, and you just think, I'm going to enjoy this town. If it's got a building that's that insane, then it's going to be a fun town. So, yeah, you know, some good restaurants, some good tapas-y type food, and, yeah, more of the same this time.
That's pretty good. It's lovely. I was saying to before we started the interview that Spain has been incredibly kind to us. Because when we started out, we were just trying to find any fans, you know. One or two fans would have been good. And so every time that we go, that we've been to another country and another place in the world and discovered there are even more fans of Keane, it's great. But particularly in Spain, there's always a great atmosphere. People seem to have really connected with... the sort of heart and the soul of our music. So we always love coming here, and it's great.
Oh, I have to give up.
That's when we know we've blown it, you know.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll probably be a bit sad, to be honest, if that does happen.
It's been great in your career.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The thing is, we don't live for that kind of thing. So I'm sure it'll hurt a bit if it doesn't happen, but it won't be the end of the world. It wouldn't necessarily be the end of Keane. I hope it wouldn't.
Yeah, it's just a bonus, you know. You make the best record you think you can make, and you hope that people like it. But, yeah, I don't know. It's crazy. If you told us, you know, we would ever have one number one, we would never believe you. You know, I think yesterday was 14 years since our first gig ever. And, you know, it feels like a long time ago, but we were just...
A long time ago.
Yeah, we were bumbling our way through. We had no idea. We were, you know, just friends who loved music, and we thought, we'll just go and play it and see if anyone comes. And we've had the same sort of bumbling, chaotic attitude ever since, you know. We're not very organised. We just sort of do what we feel is right, and thankfully, people seem to like it.
Well, this guy, Jesse, he sort of... He joined us for a couple of gigs, and then we've not been able to get rid of him.
Yeah, he was like, "Shall I just stay? I'll come to the next rehearsal, and then you know, I'll just come on this tour with you, and you know, I'll come to the studio and make this record with you." And you know, we've never invited him. You know, we don't actually like him.
No.
But he doesn't really fit in. He's not very funny. He smells quite a lot. And yeah, I don't know why. We're just too polite. You know, it's like when that drunk guy is talking to you in the bar and you can't, you're too polite to tell them to fuck off, you know, that's Jesse. And, you know.
Yeah. We really love him, as you can tell. He plays all right, yeah.
He's good.
He's just about bad enough to play in Keane.
He used to be really good, but now he's just sort of average.
We brought him down, yeah. Well, it was just an accident. It was an accident. I mean, we had a guitarist, as you said. We had four people, then we're three, and now we're four again. But we had a guitarist. We basically were just a bit of a... We were a rip-off of somewhere between sort of U2 and Radiohead, which was kind of a nice place to be, but we were kind of pretty derivative and not very original as a band. And then our guitarist left. Tim wrote a load of great songs, and we had to find a way of doing them without a guitar. So that's how the sound of Keane developed into what it became. Tim playing the piano, Richard playing the drums, me singing, and it's not changed dramatically since then. I mean, we certainly experimented with the individual sounds, what we do, and with the third album, I guess we used a lot of different instruments. But it's not changed dramatically.
Tim writes most of the songs on the piano, not all of them, but most of them, and that's sometimes where they just seem to sound best. There is a book by an artist called Tracy Emin about the place she grew up in, and she called the book Strangeland, and that's sort of the area that we all grew up in as well, so that was sort of her name for it, but it just seemed appropriate for the sort of crazy journey that is your life. You know, for everyone, life is different to what you expect when you're a kid, or more complicated, or just weirder. And I think this record looks back at where we're from, but also looking forward at how you experience that life and where you go with it and the excitement of the possibilities of the future. That's interesting.
Don't know, really.
Is it the most Britpop album we've ever...
That's it's a British good... and it's pop.
Yeah, I mean, we love pop music. We were, you know, we were starting out as a band when Britpop was happening, so I'm sure it's in our blood. And, you know, I think our instincts are to make pop music that is, you know, good, catchy 3.5 minute songs. So, I think the good end of pop is really magical.
We've got some European festivals, like this one, obviously, and then we take a bit of time off. And then we're all over the place.
Yeah, literally. We're going to Asia and all over the world, and then we come back to Europe in November. I think we're playing in Pamplona and Barcelona and Madrid, part of a massive European tour, which is going to be great fun. So, if you couldn't make it to this one, come and see us then. Hi, I'm Richard.
I'm Tom, we're from the band Keen, and you are watching BFM.
This town was a lover's stage, but now you can't recognize the streetlights through the daggers to your eyes. You can't find your bearings, you're slipping into the ground. The scene has no color and no sound. Do you still believe in me after the things I've done? Do you fear for what we have become? The ground is uneven, we stumble from day to day. Each other where it's easy, I know you feel like lead, but you gotta get on. features I've been navigating by. No, nothing looks the way it did before. I don't know where to look up, what to look for. I feel like I just don't know you anymore. But I've been burned and I've been down so many times. We walk in circles, the blind leading the blind. We've been disconnected somehow. There's an invisible wall between us now. But I've been wrong and I've been down so many times. We walk in circles, the blind leading the blind. We've been disconnected somehow. There's an invisible wall between us now.
Thank you. People of Bilbao, people of the Bay Basque, thank you!